honey, yummy, gooey, viscous, liquid gold. The poets loved it.
Egyptians? They would be obsessed. They loved the stuff, healed their wounds with it, and even sent it to the afterlife. Why? This stuff lasts forever.
Above the ground? Sure, we see a hive of activity, but below the surface, let's take a closer look. Way closer.
I've put honey under the microscope and I don't think you're going to believe what I found.
Bees don't just randomly visit flowers. They're actually looking for a charge. You see, flowers have a little positive charge, and bees, they build up a negative charge while they're flying.
Like when you rub a balloon on your hair.
When a bee lands, that little zap helps them know which flowers still have nectar. And once they find it, they slurp up the good stuff.
Now, we should clear something up. Honey is actually bee bath.
Back at the hive, the bees vomit the nectar into their waxy, hexagonal storage units.
And when it's dry, the bees seal it with a layer of wax.
But is all honey the same? I've collected honey from local beehives, Parliament House's hives, and got myself some of the supermarket brands.
Then we put them under the microscope, and wow! Every honey sample told a different story of bees, flowers, crystallization, and environmental struggle, even fungi.
The diagnostic of acacia pollen is that it has many cells stuck together. The eucalypt is that it's flat and has three claws.
And I found a lot of other pollen too, like daisy pollen, which has very pronounced spikes.
Next time you grab a jar of honey, just remember, you're eating more than just breakfast. You're eating a bouquet of flowers.
Nice to meet you.